Applied dimensional analysis, physics applications. With more complicated dimensional analysis problems, we start with a given quantity. And use conversion rates to find its result or equivalent. Let's look at example one. In example one, we have the acceleration of an object moving through space was measured at 91 feet per minute squared. What is this in meters per second squared? So, first thing that we need to be able to do is know what our conversion units are going to be. So, because we have feet to meters, we're going to need to go feet to inches. And from inches to centimeters. And then from centimeters to meters. And then we need to go from minutes to seconds. We have that 1 minute is equal to 60 seconds. So these are all the conversions that I am going to be using. So we start with what was given, and that's the 91 feet per minute squared. We're going to start with our top unit first. So we want to do feet, and so we look for our conversion that has feet in it, and we put that one in place. So I'll have 1 foot is 12 inches. So now feet are gone, and I've used that conversion. Now I have inches, so I want to look for a conversion that has inches, and that will be this one. So I have 1 inch is 2.54 centimeters. Now inches are gone, leaving me with centimeters, and so I'm looking for my conversion that has centimeters in it. And so I have that 100 centimeters is 1 meter. So centimeters now are gone. Now meters was what I was looking for. So we've gotten there. Now we need to go from minutes to seconds. And so I have a conversion of 1 minute equals to 60 seconds. Now because minute is squared, that means I need to be squaring my conversion also. And I can do it by one way of just writing it twice or using it twice, or you can use your squared button. Okay, so now it's a matter of putting it into my calculator. Everything on top is multiplied, everything in the denominator is divided. So I took 91 times 12 times 2.54 divided by 100 divided by 60, divided by 60, and I got that this equaled 0.0077 meters per second squared. So let's take a look at our second example. In our second example, it says a car's footprint is a square about 5.89 inches on one side. Estimate the average pressure beneath one tire due to the weight of the car in pounds per inches squared. And they give us the weight of the car. So when the tire is touching the ground, it creates a square. So 5.89 is our dimensions for our square. So when we go to put this in, It tells us that we're going to be in pounds per inches. That means we want our weight to be on top, inches to be in the denominator. So we're going to start with 5.47 tons over 5.89, and we're going to be multiplying this because it's a square, 5.89, and this will be inches squared. Now the only thing I have to convert here is to convert my tons to pounds, and we have a conversion for that, that 2,000 pounds is equal to 1 ton. Now the other thing to keep in mind here is that I have four tires. So this dimension here is for one tire. In order to get it for four tires, I need to multiply that by four. Okay, so now I'm going to convert my tons. My tons is on top, so I'm going to put ton on the bottom, and we're going to put 2,000 pounds on top. So tons is gone, and that leaves me with pounds per inches squared. So I'm actually going to be going 5.47 times 2,000 divided by 4 divided by my 5.89 divided by my 5.89, unless I had actually multiplied this part here first. Now I get that this equals 78.836 pounds per inches squared. And I'm done.